guest is the founder of the world's first cupcake bakery, Sprinkles Cupcakes, and she's here today to show us how to make her signature vanilla cupcakes and turn them into so much more.
So much more,
There's
Debbie.
So much more than just the regular old cupcake. Please welcome the cupcake queen herself, Miss Candace Nelson. Also joining us at the counter from Days of Our Lives, Mr. Lamone Archie and his beautiful fiance, Mercedes Cornett. Welcome, we're so excited to have you. So Candace, this wasn't always the career path you were gonna take. It's not even the career path you were on for so many years. And then one day you woke up and you said, that's it.
Listen, I went from banking to baking.
Wow.
I started off out of college in investment banking. I was working with technology companies. It was the first dot-com boom, the late 90s. Oh, wow. And then subsequently, the dot-com bust.
Ouch.
The economy tanked. I was out of a job. And I really had to look inward and think, what is it that I want to do with my life?
Right.
And I wanted to do something I was passionate about, and that for me was baking.
I mean, that's so interesting because the natural progression from there is you think, okay, let me go to business school.
Right, exactly. Someone with my, you know,
with
education
your degree,
and,
yeah.
and working in banking, the next step logically,
business
it was
school.
Business school. It's what all my friends were doing. I didn't want to take the expected path. I really wanted to follow my passion. And I went to pastry school, and I realized it just fed my soul. I loved working with my hands. I loved making artful, beautiful, tasty desserts. And I kind of found my thing.
And we launched right in here.
No, you guys
should Listen, when you're working with ice cream, you got to take right
in. Isn't that interesting? Like, you did what you loved,
right,
and the universe responded, and you became the queen of cupcakes because
you're
you were doing, you know what I mean?
Right now.
Mm-hmm. You're feeding Larissa's soul and so much more.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, I think it's really important to do what you're passionate about because we spend so many hours of our day working,
so
right?
True.
So who wants to be miserable doing their job? And so you're right. I had no idea if anyone would, you know,
respond, but they
respond.
Did.
Respond. The world's first cupcakes only bakery
right
started in LA. Everybody said nobody even eats carbs in
right
LA.
Yeah.
So,
oh, yeah, they do. And now you even have like the vending machine
yes
where you can get cupcakes. It's crazy.
24 hours a day. Cupcake
vending machine. This is nuts.
Yeah, 2 o'clock in the morning, we've got you covered.
That's right.
Got you
but like the people say, do what you love and you'll never work a day in your
yes
life. And that's really
yeah
what you're doing.
The rest will follow. So we're going to start by, I'm going to show you the Sprinkles vanilla cupcake recipe. We already have our butter, our sugar, and our eggs that
okay
are creamed in here. And what we're going to do to finish off this recipe is just add the dry ingredients and the wet ingredients
okay
alternating. So I'll leave the wet ingredients to you.
Is this almond milk?
So no, it looks like a different color because we have our milk and our vanilla extract
oh
already
okay
combined.
Smart.
So
okay
I'm going to add this flour and leavening.
Okay.
And while this is blending up,
just
yep,
like
you've got
that
the wet ingredients covered. And this was actually the first cupcake recipe that I developed for Sprinkles.
Really?
The vanilla cupcake. You can get it with vanilla frosting, chocolate frosting.
How long did it take you to get the perfect ratio of this to that to figure out the perfect cupcake? Because it really is the perfect cupcake.
Oh, thank
it's so
you
moist.
You
know,
guys
some
are
cupcakes
so
get dry. Your
so
cupcakes
sweet
don't get dry
on this show. And I love how much you all love dessert on this show.
Yeah.
I feel
how
like I'm among kindred
yeah
spirits here.
We like food, Candace.
I love it. I'm
we
coming back tomorrow. Okay, so we're just going to dump the rest of that in.
Okay.
And we're just waiting for the batter to get
come
smooth
together
and blended. You might want to kind of
scrape the sides.
Scrape it down.
There you go.
But it did. It took a while. It took a lot of trial and error. My husband and I used to.
Oh prove boy, there's some trial and error right there.
Here, we'll turn it
there
off.
There we go, we got it.
When you have it on
injuries
a slow setting,
no injuries.
Is that you don't want to put it on a high setting? Is that?
So once you put the flour in, you actually don't want to agitate the dough too much
okay
or the batter because it will exercise the glutens. Not to get too technical.
And then it won't be moist.
And it won't oh be tender.
Get technical. I love
it. Be tender. So we want to.
There's
you know,
a science behind it.
Right?
Once your batter is all blended up, we're just going to scoop into our cupcake pan.
Well,
and
I love that you share the recipe. I think that's mm-hmm so
I
great
know
because some
thank
people would
you
be like, oh no, it's so successful, I'd want to keep it a secret, but you share that so that everybody anywhere can enjoy it.
She left out three ingredients.
Exactly.
Don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
I totally left out the butter.
Right.
No, Sprinkles has 25 locations across the U.S., but still, there are a lot of people who would love a Sprinkles cupcake
right
and they can't get to a bakery. Mm-hmm. So it really was for, you know, everyone, but really for those people who can't get their hands on a freshly baked Sprinkles, now you can make them yourself.
And I love your, this isn't actually an ice cream scoop. It's a...
We use these at the bakery. It's called a disher, and it's basically an ice cream scoop with a, you know, a little squeezy thing that releases. A squeezy thing is the technical term for it.
So cool.
Like a spring release.
So you get the perfect size each time.
It's important to get the same amount of batter in each one, so they bake in the same amount of time.
Of course.
So we're going to get this into an oven at 350 degrees.
Okay. For how long?
Bake for about 18 minutes until the tops are dry, and by the magic of TV, ta-da!
Beautiful.
You said until the tops are dry, so are you not a poke in and see the wet?
I don't love using, I think if you're making a recipe for the first time, it's good to use a tester, but for me it's kind of like, think of a grill master, right? They don't use anything like a thermometer to test their steaks. They just touch it. It's a touch test. And so with, you know, bakers who've baked things a lot, I think you can just tell by the press of a fingertip.
Okay.
So let's get these cupcakes out of their little resting spots.
Okay.
And
what do we
this
do?
Is where the magic happens.
All
okay.
Right.
These cupcakes are so versatile, such a simple little dessert, but we're going to make two magical desserts out of them.
We're making this berry trifle, which I'm so excited
First, we're going to make, this berry trifle is so beautiful. I love a trifle because it has such impact.
I know,
but
it's
a really simple. And not just out of these are out of cupcakes. So I need your help actually unwrapping these guys and then cutting off the heads from the bottoms of the cupcakes.
Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna
I'm decapitating the cupcake.
Well, yes.
Okay, there we go.
There we go. So we're gonna
pull
save
it off
these
and I'll do this.
Cupcake tops for later, and we're gonna use these bottoms to help construct our beautiful summer berry trifle.
Okay, so
and
you
this
go ahead
one's
and I'll
already
cut these.
Started. We're just gonna crumble these bits of cupcake bottoms to add another layer to this trifle.
Nice.
And you know, a trifle is actually a traditionally British dessert, but this is looking very USA, don't you think, people?
It's perfect for 4th of July.
It's perfect for 4th of July. And really, this is sort of the, if you're doing, you know, a 4th of July celebration, this is kind of a lighter feeling. I don't know if it's lighter calorically. It's lighter feeling. And with the berries and the whipped cream, it's sort of a nice recipe for the adults.
Trifle always feels light to me.
Yeah.
I think it's the whipped cream.
Whipped cream and berries.
Yeah,
it's just something so summery.
I feel like, it's probably calorie-free.
Yeah, well, obviously.
I'm pretty sure it is.
That's what you guys...
It's not too sweet either. It has
Yeah, exactly. So
we're going to add our layer of whipped cream. And the thing that's fun about trifle, it's not too precious. You can have fun with it. So you can add, you know, lemon curd. You can add raspberry or strawberry jam to this. You can really kind of make it your own. But obviously here we're you know, you don't want to spend a lot of time in the kitchen during the summer, so we're keeping it really simple.
Well, and while you're doing that, just tell us about your upcoming Netflix show.
Yeah, so I have a new show coming out on Netflix, which I'm really excited about. It's called Sugar Rush. Here, I'll let you do the final.
Okay.
And it's a dessert competition show. I get to judge.
Yay!
That's so fun.
Episodes will be streaming on July 13th. And I'm really excited for everyone to see it. There's so much great talent on the show. I get to taste so many delicious.
That must be so difficult, though.
It's difficult? How? Tasting delicious desserts?
No, I mean to choose.
It's
because
it's,
I bet there's so much good stuff.
There's so much great talent. So, but I luckily I'm tasting and not competing, so I get the easy job.
That is. Right
and so
there.
That's for your adults, and then the kids at your
Do we need a spoon?
A little spoon. Yeah.
Stand by.
Thank you very much. Oh, very nice. So for the kids at your July 4th celebration, obviously they'll be screaming for ice cream. So we take these cupcake tops.
How cute is that? Oh. And tell me, is that your red velvet ice cream?
This is the Sprinkles red velvet ice cream because, you know, Sprinkles makes ice cream now, too.
You make the best red velvet cupcakes I've ever eaten in my life.
That's for you. Wow. And how did you guys enjoy yours?
Amazing.
Oh, it was brilliant.
Amazing.
And it's really fun. You can make an ice cream bar and put out all the different flavors and really let the kids have fun with it.